first fight of the night after you've been in the UFC for a while.
Correct.
Do you feel like you made your case to get off of there?
Oh, I certainly hope so. You know, the fighter meeting after Wayne's, you know, they said, hey, you know, you're not happy with your place in the card, go out there and get noticed, do something. So that's what there was motivation for me, man. I wanted to go out there and, you know, win in dramatic fashion, and I got that TKO from that short left, so hopefully that's a step in the right direction to get me back in the main card.
Were they talking directly to you when they said that?
No, they're just, you know, generally making a statement, you know, because some people, there's been a lot of talk about fighter pay, right, position on the card, this, that, and the other thing. So, you know, they said, hey, it's in your hands. Go out there and do something, you know, make a statement.
Is this something that did we make that into a deal, or did you also feel like, hey, this is kind of crap that I'm on the Facebook prelims after all the time I've been here?
Well, every fighter wants to be on the main card, myself included. And so, you know, I just knew that if I want to get back in that position, I have to do something. You know, guys, everybody that pays good money to see these shows, they want to see those finishes. They want to see, you know, it doesn't matter if it's a TKO, a knockout, a submission. They want to see awesome finishes. And that's, you know, I always go out there to try and do that. And, you know, I was just fortunate enough to put things together through a long training camp to make that happen tonight.
Now that brings you to a 4-fight win streak. How do you feel about your place in the division?
You know, I think my spot in the welterweight division is pretty good. You know, I see myself as a top 10 guy. I haven't gotten knocked out. I haven't gotten submitted by anybody. The only guys I've lost to are guys that have either had title shots or going to have title shots. You know, Johnny Hendricks coming up here against GSP. So, you know, I feel pretty good about where I belong in the division, and we'll see what the cards hold for the next time.
Do you feel at all that you're being underrated as far as your place there? Or?
I kind of always feel like I've been the underdog in life. You know, it doesn't matter what sport I've ever participated in. I've always been the guy that has been kind of overlooked or, you know, slightly underrated. So that's fine to me. I'm cool with that. Let them underestimate me. Let them overlook me, and I'll come back and surprise them.
That first round, you were up against you had him up against the fence. What did your corner tell you going into the second round?
A lot more footwork, you know, more work off the brakes, and just, you know, get with the program, get more action going, and that's what I wanted to do. I mean, you know, watching his last few fights, very high-paced fighter, like to get in your face, close the distance, and I kind of wanted to wear him down a little bit and get him tired and fatigued, and I think I did that enough in the first round to kind of open up more opportunities in the second and capitalized on it.
At what point in time did you feel like you really needed to go for the kill?
When the bell rang. You know, I'm always looking for that opportunity to put the fight away early. So, you know, the opportunity just presented itself, and I caught him with a short left.
You talked about them saying, hey, it's in your hands. You know, this is what people want to see. If that's where, you know, if you want to get off into the main card, that's what you have to do. I mean, how does that affect your game planning? I mean, because that seems like it doesn't necessarily fit with your strengths. I mean, what you usually do.
You know, for me as a fighter in the UFC, I'm always going to try and look to put somebody away. I mean, everybody knows that sometimes if it goes to decision, you don't always get the decision that you're looking for. And so for me, getting the finish is always the icing on the cake. You know, you put all this time and hard work in, and it pays off. But, you know, I don't try and replay those thoughts in my head too much during the fight or leading up to the fight, because it's just going to throw me out of my game. I just go in there and do what I do, and when an opportunity presents itself, take it.
How much do you think it's going to take to change that perception of you, you know, to show people, hey, you can go out there and finish fights? I mean, do you think that this one is enough? Do you think you have to kind of get a few in a row going?
You know, I don't know if this is enough, but I think it's certainly a step in the right direction to, you know, maybe change people's perspective. Maybe go, hey, you know what, this guy is pretty tough. He's got some tools. He's knocked people out with both hands. He hasn't ever been, you know, choked out or never been knocked out. So, you know, I feel pretty good about where I'm at.
You came in with a game plan. Obviously, you did study David Mitchell. Did he bring anything to this fight that you were surprised about?
His takedown defense was a little bit better than I anticipated, but that's fine. You know, I was telling people earlier, you know, in the clinch, I feel pretty secure and strong there, especially when I got someone smashed up against the cage. There's not a lot of guys that are going to beat me in that domain, and I felt like I was in control. He'd never hit me with anything that surprised me. He's not any different than any other fighter I've ever faced, so.
Is it at least nice to get, I mean, it's like 4:30 in the afternoon, your work's done for the day.
Yes, it's nice. I get to go and sit and relax with my girlfriend and my daughter that are here and watch the rest of the card. It's going
to
be nice.
Does it affect your bottom line to be on the Facebook? I mean, does it affect your sponsor pay, stuff like that?
Oh, well, certainly. I mean, sponsors pay for more money for the prime time, you know, every time. So, I mean, yeah, it's going to, you know, be a little different than had I been higher up in the card, but you know, that this was another opportunity to get myself in that spot and make more money on sponsors. So, Hopefully that happens.
Like, how different? I mean, is it a difference of, like, you know, 10 grand or, you know?
Probably close to that. Yeah. Yes, yeah. I mean, they do pay pretty good for, you know, pay-per-view slots.
What's Mike Pierce going to do after this fight to celebrate?
You know, I'm going to go in the stands, sit down with my girlfriend and my daughter and watch the rest. And then when I get home, probably going to have a feast over at my parents' house with the rest of the team.
Who do you like, Anderson Spider Silva or Chris Weidman?
I'm always going to root for the wrestler. So it's Chris Weidman all the way for me.
Thank you, Mike.
Yeah, appreciate it. Thanks, Mike.